Hello students, welcome to the class. So previous class we have discussed about amines. Now here we have cyanides and isocyanides. Cyanides, these are, we have discussed already. Let us see briefly the preparation and reactions. These are alkyl derivatives of hydrogen cyanide which exist in two tautomeric forms. So we have cyanides and isocyanides. Cyanides from alkyl halides. Alkyl halides when treated with KCN, we get cyanides. If you treat it with AgCN, we get isocyanides. From acid amides, phosphorus pentoxide, it is a dehydrating agent, elimination of water takes place, and we get cyanide. Yes, so you can see example also. From Grignard's reagent, when Grignard's reagent is treated with cyanogen chloride, we get cyanide. ClCN is called cyanogen chloride. This is the best method for preparation of tertiary alkyl cyanides. Yes, tertiary alkyl cyanides. By dehydration of aldoxime. Aldoxime is nothing but RCH double bond NOH. We see, we know it. When it is treated with a dehydrating agent, that is phosphorus pentoxide, or you can take acetic anhydride, we get cyanide with the elimination of water. From primary amines, when you treat it with copper or nickel at 500 degrees Celsius, we get cyanides. Removal of hydrogen, dehydration reaction, we get cyanides. Alkyl cyanides are sweet smelling, fairly stable liquids. Lower alkyl cyanides are soluble in water, with which they can form hydrogen bonds, and higher are insoluble. They are poisonous but less than hydrogen cyanide. Chemical properties, one is reduction. Cyanides, we know it, when it is subjected for reduction, we get amines. If you are using lithium aluminum hydride, sodium borohydride, hydrogen in nickel or platinum catalyst, we get primary amines. Stefan's reaction, when cyanides are treated with a mixture of stannous chloride and HCl, we get aldehyde, which on further hydrolysis gives us aldehyde. Stefan's reaction is one wherein you are treating a cyanide in presence of a mixture, reducing mixture, that is stannous chloride and HCl, to get aldehyde. So cyanides are reduced to aldehydes by Stefan's reaction. Mendes reaction, whenever the term Mendes reaction comes, it is using reducing agent, that is sodium in alcohol. So it involves reduction of cyanide with sodium in alcohol to give primary amines. Hydrolysis, cyanides undergo hydrolysis to give sodium salts and ammonia is released. Ethanolysis, cyanides when treated with ethyl alcohol, they form esters. They form esters. You can look at the reactions also. Reaction with Grignard's reagent. When cyanides are treated with Grignard's reagent followed by hydrolysis, we get ketones. Ketones are obtained. So what are isocyanides? Isocyanides, how they are prepared? It is RNC. When it is treated with KCN, we get cyanide. When it is treated with silver cyanide, we get AgCN, we get isocyanide. Isocyanides having the foul smell, they are also called carbylamines. Another method is from carbylamine reaction, that is when amines are treated with chloroform and KOH, we get isocyanide. Isocyanides are also called carbylamines, therefore the reaction is also called carbylamine reaction. Then with N-alkyl formamide, yes, N-alkyl formamide, R, N, or to nitrogen alkyl group is attached, therefore we write it as N-alkyl. NHCHO group is called formamide group. So RNHCHO when treated with phosphorus oxychloride gives us isocyanide. Alkyl isocyanides are colorless, unpleasant smelling liquids with lower boiling points than cyanides. They are not very soluble in water because nitrogen atom does not have lone pairs and it will not form hydrogen bond with that. Isocyanides are much more poisonous than cyanides. Chemical properties. Isocyanides, they are hydrolyzed by dilute acids, but you cannot take alkalis, and it gives amines. When hydrolysis of isocyanides is taken, we get amines. Reduction. Alkyl isocyanides are reduced to secondary amines either by dissolving metals, by catalytic reduction. Look at the reaction. Isocyanide with metal or acid, we get secondary amines. Typical reaction. Action of heat. When isocyanides are heated for a long time, we get cyanides. The reaction interchanges, we get cyanides. Addition reaction. Alkyl isocyanides give addition reactions due to presence of unshared electron pairs on carbon. Remember students, it is not on hydrogen, sorry, it is not on nitrogen, it is on carbon, because nitrogen does not have lone pairs in isocyanates. So they show addition reaction because of unshared electron pair present on carbon. Carbon is having only three bonds there. So there is one lone pair available on carbon that will make it undergo addition reactions. With chlorine, you get the compound methyl iminocarbonyl chloride. With sulfur, you get methyl isothiocyanate. With mercuric oxide, you get methyl isocyanate, and it is a very deadly, dangerous, poisonous gas, which was being found in Bhopal tragedy. It was because of methyl isocyanate. 1984 Bhopal tragedy was due to MIC, methyl isocyanate. Yes, so this is a few introductions regarding cyanides and isocyanates. Now what we are going to discuss is, we are going to discuss about biomolecules, another organic chemistry topic. In biomolecules, biomolecules are those which are biomolecules, molecules required for life, are called biomolecules. And we have carbohydrates, we have lipids, we have fats, we have vitamins, we have proteins. All these are biomolecules. Starting with carbohydrates, which these all help in various reasons. Some of them help for growth, some of them provide energy for the metabolic activities, some of them are immunoboosters. Yes. So what are carbohydrates then? Carbohydrates, they are basically for energy. So only students, when we are doing fasting, yes, if you have observed your parents doing, mothers doing fasting, or if you basically do fasting, usually we eat sweet. The reason why we eat sweet, we get instant energy, because sweet is nothing but glucose, carbohydrate. It is a sugar and it provides us instant energy. So carbohydrate, CXH2OY, it has water molecules. All the compounds satisfying this particular form are not carbohydrates. Example, C3H6O3 is not a carbohydrate. There are some carbohydrates which do not satisfy the general formula. For example, and there are examples you can see there. A close study of properties of carbohydrates reveal that they are optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones. Yes, we already know this basic definition of carbohydrates. Classification of carbohydrates. They are broadly classified as sugars and non-sugars. Non-sugars are nothing but polysaccharides. So here, sugars, they are classified as monosaccharides and oligosaccharides. And polysaccharides comes under non-sugars. So carbohydrates, sugars and non-sugars. In sugars, you have monosaccharides and oligosaccharides. In non-sugars, you have polysaccharides. So monosaccharides containing only one sugar unit, they are further classified. We will not discuss much about classification because you have studied very well under the theoretical part of it. Monosaccharides, we have aldoses, ketoses. Aldoses, because they have aldehydic group, CHO. Ketoses, because they have ketonic group. And even depending upon the number of carbon atoms also, we have classification. That is, you call them as pentose, you call them as trios, tetros. Trios means three carbon atoms. You have glyceraldehyde. Tetros, that means four carbon atoms. You have erythros, pentose, pentose sugars, which are present in DNA. Deoxyribose pentose sugar and ribose pentose sugar, yes. And hexose. Hexose are nothing but your glucose, fructose, galactose are your hexose. Yes. So this is monosaccharides. Oligosaccharides. Oligosaccharides means they contain 2 to 10 sugar units. So you have disaccharides, trisaccharides, tetrasaccharides, and so on. Yes. So polysaccharides, you have only 2 types. That is, you have 3 examples in polysaccharides. More than 10 sugar units. That is your starch, cellulose, and glycogen. Yes. Then you can look at the structure, Fischer projection for glucose and fructose. There is aldehydic group, CHO, and here there is ketonic group. Sugars, they are sweet tasting crystalline solids soluble in water. They may be reducing or non-reducing sugars. Reducing sugars, they are called so because they reduce tolerance reagent and Fehling solution. All these very weak oxidizing reducing agents are being reduced. Therefore, those are called reducing sugars. Monosaccharides, simplest carbohydrates. This is a very typical detailed topic. We don't have much of the reactions here. So we should be knowing all the terms and terminologies in this topic. They are simplest carbohydrates which cannot be hydrolyzed into smaller or simple units. That is the prior definition of carbohydrates, you know, optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones, or which give these on hydrolysis. sometimes sucrose on hydrolysis gives us polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones, right? It gives glucose and fructose. So they are all examples of sugars, that is carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are commonly called sugars, or you can call them as saccharides. A monosaccharide can be a polyhydroxyaldehyde, example glucose, called aldose, or a polyhydroxyketone, example fructose, called ketones. Polyhydroxyaldehydes are called aldoses, and polyhydroxyketones are called ketoses. The simplest monosaccharide being 2,3-dihydroxypropanol. It is nothing but glyceraldehyde. 2,3-dihydroxypropanol and 1,3-dihydroxypropanone. Yes, aldose and ketose. Oligosaccharides. Oligosaccharides are the carbohydrates that yield 2 to 8 monosaccharide units on hydrolysis. Carbohydrates which yield 2 monosaccharide units are called disaccharides, which give 3 monosaccharide units are called trisaccharides, and so on. The 3 most important disaccharides are sucrose, maltose, and lactose. Each of these on hydrolysis with either an acid or an enzyme gives 2 molecules of same or different, like this. You can see here. Sucrose on hydrolysis using an enzyme that is invertase. It will give you, please remember the enzymes also. Sucrose on hydrolysis, the name, it is called invertase because this reaction is called inversion of cane sugar. It gives us glucose and fructose. You may say why it is called inversion, because sucrose is dextrorotatory. But when you carry out hydrolysis of sucrose, you will get a mixture of glucose and fructose, but fructose is obtained in more proportion. Glucose is dextrorotatory, fructose is levorotatory. So there is a change of configuration from dextro to levorotatory. Therefore, this reaction is called inversion of cane sugar, and therefore the enzyme used is called invertase. Maltose on subjecting for hydrolysis using maltase enzyme gives us 2 molecules of glucose. Lactose on hydrolysis using lactase enzyme gives a molecule of glucose and galactose. Then polysaccharides are polymers of monosaccharides. They contain about 100 to 3000 monomer units, monosaccharide units. The most abundant polysaccharides are cellulose, starch, and glycogen. Reducing and non-reducing sugars. Carbohydrates may be also classified as reducing and non-reducing. Those carbohydrates which will give reaction with all these mild oxidizing agents like Pelling, Stollens, Benedict's reagents, they are called reducing sugars. All the monosaccharides are, whether aldose or ketose, are reducing. All the monosaccharides are reducing. But in disaccharides, only if the reducing group of monosaccharide is bonded, they become non-reducing. Yes. See, the sucrose is non-reducing. All monosaccharides, glucose, fructose, galactose, are reducing sugars. In disaccharides, there are 3, sucrose, maltose, and lactose. Sucrose is non-reducing, whereas maltose and lactose are reducing sugars. So DL rotation, simplest aldose, and the only one whose name does not end with O's is glyceraldehyde and aldotriose, you can see. And then D and L notation, it is not small d, small l. Small d, small l stands for, or plus sign and minus sign stands for dextro and levo. Capital D, capital L is obtained from glyceraldehyde where the OH group is present. If the OH group is present on left side, it is D. If it is present on right side, it is L. Yes. So it is D and L notation. D glyceraldehyde is R plus glyceraldehyde, whereas L glyceraldehyde is S minus glyceraldehyde. The notations D and L are used to describe the configuration of carbohydrates and amino acids. Similarly, you have galactose D and L notation. You can see there OH group is on this side and here OH group is on left side. If OH group is attached to bottommost asymmetric carbon on the right side, it is D sugar. If it is on the left side, it is L sugar. Yes, almost all the sugars are present as D, capital D. Capital D stands for OH group on the right side. Small capital L stands for OH group on the left side. So then along with that, you have R and S configuration also. D and L indicate the configuration of asymmetric carbon, but do not indicate whether the compound rotates polarized light or no. That is from plus and minus. D glyceraldehyde is dextrorotatory, whereas D lactic acid is levorotatory. So if you want to represent lactic acid, I write it as D minus lactic acid. What does that indicate? D means OH group is on the right side. Minus means The lactic acid is levorotatory. It will rotate the plane polarized light towards left. So these all things you should be, conventions should be known. It is made, these conventions are given to make the understanding easy for us. Common name of monosaccharide, yes, with D and L designation completely defines its structure because relative configuration of all asymmetric carbons are implicit in common name. Preparation of glucose, it is by hydrolysis of sucrose using acid or invertase enzyme, you get glucose and fructose, or from starch, hydrolysis using acid, we get glucose. The free acid is neutralized with calcium carbonate and filtered. The filtrate is decolorized by animal charcoal and concentrated in vacuum pans to give crystals of glucose. Properties, it is a white crystalline solid. If you look at the melting point, you can see it rotates the plane polarized light towards right side. Hence, it is named. Glucose is also named as dextrose. Yes, it is also known as dextrose. Even not just dextrose, it is also known as glucose pyranose, glucopyranose. Yes, you will come to, when you see the Havard structures of glucose, you will understand it better. And this is Havard structure, a cyclic structure of glucose. You can see there is a six-membered ring, and one carbon atom is at the top. You can see it. This is the structure of glucose. Yes, it is the structure of glucose, which is called as a Havard structure. Yes. So how the explanation? Anomers are what? Alpha. You can see that in the structure, alpha D glucose and beta D glucose are called anomers. Anomers are what? They are the two sugars that differ in configuration only at carbon. That was the carbonyl carbon in the open chain. Yes, you can see in the open chain, it was carbonyl carbon. When it forms a ring structure, that carbon, when differ in the configuration, is such carbons, such compounds are called anomers. Ano stands for upper. This anomers differ in configuration at the uppermost carbon. The anomeric carbon is only carbon in the molecule that is bonded to two oxygens. Alpha and beta defines the configuration of anomeric carbon. Anomers like epimers are particular kind of distereomers. They differ in the configuration only at carbon atom. In aqueous solution, the open chain compound is in equilibrium with the two cyclic hemiacetals, that is alpha and beta. Formation of cyclic hemiacetals proceeds merely to so very little glucose exists in open chain. So most exist in D-glucose, beta D-glucose is more, then comes alpha D-glucose, and open chain is very less. When crystals of pure alpha D glucose are dissolved in water, specific rotation gradually changes from, this is called mutar rotation. It changes from 112 to 52.7 degrees. See, you can see that large point, you can see. The specific rotation of the equilibrium mixture is 52.7 degrees. This is why same specific rotation results whether the crystals originally dissolved in water are alpha D glucose or beta D glucose. A slow change in the optical rotation to an equilibrium value is known as mutar rotation. If an aldose can form 5 or 6-membered ring, it will exist predominantly as cyclic hemiacetal in solution. Whether a 5 or 6-membered ring is formed depends on the relative stability. 6-membered rings are called pyranoses. So only glucose is called glucopyranose. Whereas 5-membered ring is called furanoses. Fructose is called fructofuranose, glucose, because it represents the structure of pyran and furan. 6-membered ring pyran, 5-membered ring furan. Consequently, alpha D glucose is called alpha D glucopyranose, and fructose is called alpha L group fructofuranose. Yes, Fischer projections are not the best way to show the structure of cyclic sugar because COC bond is represented. Therefore, which structure is obtained? Havard's projection is there. You can look here. Havard's projection. You should be knowing for alpha and beta glucose, this is the structure. For alpha and beta fructose and for all the disaccharides. Test for glucose. Glucose when treated with NaOH gives us yellow brown resin. When treated with Tollens reagent forms a silver mirror. Fehling's reagent forms the red precipitate. Mollisch test. Alpha naphthol, glucose plus alpha naphthol plus ethyl alcohol gives us indigo color. fructose. You can look at the structure, alpha fructose and beta fructose. These are Haworth structures. Yes. Fructose is a reducing sugar. All the tolerance test, it gives silver test, silver PPT. Fellings test solution, it gives red PPT. Fructose is a ketonic sugar, yet it yields tolerance test. It is due to the fact under, it gives a mixture of glucose, mannose and fructose. Therefore, it will reduce all these reagents. Yes. Sucrose, cane sugar, disaccharide, naturally occur in sugar, cane and beetroot. It is also found in pineapples, honey, banana and several ripened fruits. Molasses is a mother liquor left after crystallization of sucrose. It is colorless, crystalline solid, highly soluble in water. Maltose, look at the Haworth structure. You should be knowing these structures which help in us excluding out the two molecules. Maltose contains two molecules of glucose and lactose contains a glucose and a galactose. So it is a white crystalline solid, highly soluble in water, and solution rotates the plane polarized right towards the right hand side. So dextrorotatory. 1/3 as sweet as cane sugar. It is a reducing sugar because it reduces Fehling's solution, tolerance reagent, peridotic solution. It forms oxime or cezone and shows the phenomenon of mutual rotation. On hydrolysis with maltase enzyme or HCl, it gives two molecules of glucose. Lactose, milk sugar. Look at the Haworth structure. Should be knowing the Haworth structure. On hydrolysis of lactose using lactase enzyme or HCl, it will give us a molecule of glucose and galactose. Yes, it is also a reducing sugar. Only which are reducing sugars? Monosaccharides. All monosaccharides are reducing sugars. Under disaccharides, maltose and lactose are reducing sugars, whereas sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Starch. Starch has got two components, amylose and amylopectin. Yes. So here, starch, it is a polysaccharide present in plants, storage polysaccharide. General formula, C6H10O5N. N stands for the sugar units, those repeating units, 200 to 1000. It consists of alpha-glucose and made up of two components, that is amylose and amylopectin. Starch is white amorphous powder with no taste and odor. It is soluble in water. It is prepared by heating ordinary starch with 10% HCl for a day. When boiled with dilute acids, it is first converted into dextrin and finally into glucose. Cellulose, present in the plants. The main source of cellulose is cotton and wool. It is most abundant carbohydrate in nature. It is useful. It forms useful products like gun cotton, cellulose acetate, rayon. These are all polymers, students. These are all polymers. Gun cotton, cellulose acetate, rayon. Clothing is what we use. Yes. Properties of cellulose. It's also a white, amorphous, tasteless, fibrous salt substance. Insoluble in water and organic solvents. It dissolves in a solution of cupric hydroxide. Cu2OH, COOH twice. In ammonia, and that is called Switzer's reagent, forms acids, alcohols, and salts. This property is used in manufacture of artificial silk, which is called rayon. Hydrolysis of sucrose, cellulose, it is completely hydrolyzed to give glucose because it is made up of glucose units only. Amino acids. Why we need to study amino acids? Because proteins contain amino acids. Amino acids are the bifunctional organic compounds. They are called bifunctional, two functional groups, NH2 and COH. And they are building blocks of proteins. Therefore, proteins are alpha amino acids. That means NH2 group is present on alpha carbon. Out of 20 amino acids, naturally 24 amino acids are known, but out of 20 amino acids are required to our body. Out of 20, 10 are non-essential and 10 are essential. So what are non-essential amino acids? Those amino acids which are already synthesized by our body and we need not take them from external diet are called non-essential. There are 10 amino acids which our body synthesizes and they are not to be need not to be taken from external diet. They are called non-essential. And what are essential amino acids? Remaining 10 amino acids which are required for our body, they cannot be synthesized by our body. Therefore, we need to take them in outside as supplements, and they are called essential amino acids. So deficiency of these amino acids causes a disease called kwashiorkor. All amino acids exist as vitrion. Zwitterion is nothing but a dipolar ion. It contains both positive and negative charges. Isoelectric point. The isoelectric point of amino acid is pH at which it has no net charge. That means positive and negative charges are not there. It exists in zwitterion form. Yes. So that is called isoelectric point. It is different for different amino acids. The isoelectric point of an amino acid that does not have any ionizable side chain such as alanine is midway between its two pKa values. Using these amino acids, we prepare, our body synthesizes proteins. So proteins are required for synthesis, for formation of hormones in our body. So basically, proteins are linear condensation polymers of alpha amino acids. Amino acids go on getting added. Yes, I'll just show you how these amino acids go on getting added. Amino acids can be represented by R, C double bond, R, CH, NH, COOH, another molecule of amino acid, HN, CH, R, COOH. Here there occurs intermolecular elimination of water. And what do I get? I get R, CH, NH, C, double bond O. And here there is NH, CH, R, COOH. When hundreds of molecules go on combining like this, so it is linear condensation with the intermolecular elimination of water. It forms this bond. This bond is called peptide bond. Yes. And this molecule is called dipeptide. So dipeptide means what? When two amino acids combine, they condense, it forms dipeptide, and there is one peptide bond. So two amino acids, the compound is called dipeptide, and there is one peptide bond. Three amino acids, the compound formed is called tripeptide, and there are two peptide bonds. Yes. Four amino acids, the compound formed is called tetrapeptide, and there are three peptide bonds. 100 amino acids, 10 to 100 amino acids, it is called polypeptide, and there are n minus 1 peptide bonds. And this chain of polypeptide is nothing but protein. What it is? Protein. So large number of amino acids undergo linear condensation to form a polypeptide with peptide bonds, and that is called what? It is called protein. So basically it contains CONH bond, which is called peptide bond. Carbohydrates contain glycosidic bond. Proteins contain peptide bonds, and therefore proteins are also called polypeptides, or you can call them as polyamides. Classification of proteins: simple proteins, conjugated proteins, derived proteins. Simple alpha amino acids we get, conjugated, complete hydrolysis, prosthetic group is present. Derived proteins, intermediate products of hydrolysis of proteins. Structure of proteins, as I said, they are condensation polymers of alpha amino acids joined together through peptide bond. Primary structure of proteins, in structures we have three: primary, secondary, and tertiary. Primary is very important. It tells us about the sequence. If there is a small change in the sequence of amino acids, the entire protein becomes new. Secondary, you have two types, alpha helical structure and beta plated structure, which are stabilized by hydrogen bonds. Tertiary, bending and folding of the polypeptide chains gives us tertiary. Enzymes, they are biological catalysts produced in living cells. They are required, they are very specific in their action. Particular reaction, particular enzyme is used. You cannot use all the enzymes for all the reactions. Yes, or a single enzyme for all the reactions. All the enzymes are conjugated proteins. There is optimum pH and temperature for proper functioning of the enzyme. So only you might have seen, if your mother puts milk for curdling, she slightly warms the milk and adds a lemon drop or a pre-kept curd to it, because but certain particular optimum temperature, the activity of enzymes becomes more. Lactobacillus enzyme is there. Yes. So you can see there some of the enzymes catalyzed reactions. Zymase, glucose or fructose into ethyl alcohol. Invertase, sucrose to glucose and fructose. maltase, maltose to glucose and two molecules of glucose. Lactase, lactose to glucose and galactose. Amylase, amylum, that is starch, to glucose. Urease, urea to ammonia and carbon dioxide. Pepsin, please do remember this, pepsin, proteins to alpha amino acids. Trypsin, proteins to alpha amino acids. Nuclease, DNA or RNA to nucleotides. Enzymes, lipase, oils or fats to glycerol. Diastase, starch to maltose, diastase. Nucleic acid, these are natural biopolymers made up of nucleotide units or polynucleotides, your DNA and RNA. Deoxyribonucleic acid, sugar unit present here is deoxyribose. Pentose sugar is present. Ribose nucleic acid, it is also a pentose sugar. Ribose sugar is present. Yes. Nucleic acids are colorless amorphous solids. The monomer unit of nucleic acids are nucleotides. Each nucleotide contains three parts. One is phosphate unit. A nucleoside is made up of base unit and sugar. If there is phosphate unit, base and sugar, it is nucleotide. Nucleoside means what? There is no phosphate unit. It is only base and sugar. Example, adenine plus ribose is adenosine. It is a nucleoside. Guanine plus ribose is guanosine, nucleoside. Cytosine plus ribose is cytidine, nucleoside. Thymine plus ribose is thymidine. It is also nucleoside. What is nucleotide? Taking that nucleoside plus phosphatic unit. That is nucleotide. And a large number of nucleotides becomes DNA or RNA. Vitamins, vital minerals are called vitamins. See, excess vitamin should be taken in very less amount, because if you take excess of vitamins, there is a disease which causes vitaminosis. And this vitamins also should not become very less. It causes deficiency diseases. Fat soluble, they get accumulated in our body as fat. They are A, D, K and E. Water soluble, they remain soluble in water and get excreted out through urine. Vitamin B and vitamin B complexes and vitamin C. So vitamin A is called retinol, found in all these deficiency which causes night blindness and xerothalmia. Cornea becomes opaque. Vitamin D, calciferol, remember the names. Cod liver oil, all these are the sources. You need to expose to sun. Deficiency causes infantile rickets, deformation of bones. Vitamin E is called tocopherol. Deficiency causes loss of sexual power of reproduction and degeneration of muscles of fibers in animals. Vitamin K, anti-hemorrhagic factor. It is indirectly necessary for normal blood coagulation. If deficiency of vitamin K is there, there will be delay in blood coagulation and blood continuously starts flowing if there is any hemorrhage. Vitamin B1, complexes, because it has many vitamins. Thiamine, B2 is called riboflavin, B6 is called pyridoxine, and B12 is called cobalamine. Vitamin B1, its deficiency, what happens? It causes beriberi, loss of appetite. Yes. Vitamin B2, riboflavin, its deficiency causes skin diseases. Vitamin B6, its deficiency causes nervous disturbances and convulsions. Vitamin B12, pernicious enema. It causes pernicious enema. The element present in vitamin B12 is cobalt. It is cobalt. Vitamin C, ascorbic acid, citrus fruits. Yes. What is the deficiency? Scurvy. It leads to anemia, dental caries, and scurvy. Yes. Chemistry in action. Drugs, analgesics. See, we can use all these chemicals in chemistry compounds, organic compounds as drugs. We can use them as biomolecules. We can use them as food preservatives. We can use them as artificial sweetening agents. Yes, all these things. These are next part of our discussion. So we know till here. Deficiency diseases should be known of all the vitamins. The names of the vitamins should be known. Yes, fat soluble are vitamin A, D, E, and K. Water soluble are vitamin B and complexes and vitamin C. So vitamin A is what? Retinol. I repeat it once again. It is found in egg, milk, cod liver oil, butter, ghee, carrots, spinach, sweet potatoes and other vegetables. It is fat-soluble vitamin. Its deficiency causes night blindness. People cannot see in night. And xerothalmia, that is cornea, becomes opaque, drying of the skin. Vitamin D, which is called as calciferol, cod liver oil, halibut liver oil, other fish liver oils. Exposed to sunshine, vitamin D is found inside the skin. Its deficiency causes rickets, deformation of bones and teeth. Vitamin E, tocopherol. It is a fat-soluble or oil-soluble vitamin. Deficiency of it causes loss of sexual power of reproduction and degeneration of muscle fibers in animals. Vitamin K, anti-hemorrhagic factor. See, normal blood coagulation, whenever we get any wounds or cuts, what happens? The blood starts flowing. After some time, a small brown patch develops here. Why? Because the blood gets coagulated because of presence of vitamin K in our body. If it is deficient, then blood do not coagulate easily. It occurs in green leafy vegetables, spinach, cabbage, cauliflower, tomato, soybean, rich bran, oats, etc. Vitamin B1, B complexes, we have B1, B2, B6, and B12. It is water-soluble vitamin and lost by heat. It is found in unpolished rice, whole cereals, yeast, egg yolk, liver, milk, green vegetables, and fruits. Its deficiency causes beriberi, that is loss of appetite. The physiological action of thiamine is due to its pyrophosphate, known as thiamine pyrophosphate, a coenzyme of carboxylase. Vitamin B2, riboflavin, it is a water-soluble, thermally stable vitamin, but is destroyed by light. Green leafy vegetables, egg yolk, liver, etc. are its sources. Most important sources, milk. Deficiency causes skin diseases. Skin becomes rough and scaly. Sore tongue and cracked lips. Vitamin B6, pyridoxine. Important source, rice polishings, yeast, cereals, liver, and legumes. Deficiency leads to nervous disturbances and convulsions. B12, cyanocobalamin, pink-colored crystalline water-soluble vitamin present in all animal tissues, liver, kidney, eggs, and beef extract. The vitamin is involved in formation of red blood cells. Deficiency in man causes pernicious anemia. What happens is the red blood cells change their shapes. Pernicious anemia, it is known as anti-pernicious anemia. So vitamin B12 is known as anti-pernicious anemia factor. Vitamin C, ascorbic acid, water-soluble vitamin, optically active vitamin. Please do remember, destroyed by cooking and exposure to air. It's also found in tomatoes, cabbage, leafy vegetables, sprouted seeds. Mainly maintains health and skin. Its deficiency causes scurvy. Yes, the development of body resistance against the diseases, deficiency causes. So it is helpful for immune, it acts as an immune booster. So vitamin C, it can fight against different diseases. So in biomolecules, we have seen carbohydrates, the bond between the higher carbohydrates is called glycosidic bond. We have seen proteins, the bonds between the proteins are called peptide bonds. Then we have seen vitamins and enzymes. Yes, so this is all about biomolecules. In the next one, we'll be discussing the questions on amines as well as biomolecules. Hope all the discussions are clear. Thank you. Take care.